la pendule fait tic tac tic tic. Les oiseaux du lac pic pac pic pic. Glou 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 font tous les dindons. Et la jolie cloche ding ding dong. Mais boum, quand notre cœur fait boum, tout avec lui dit boum. Et c'est l'amour qui s'éveille. Boum, il chante Loving Bloom au rythme de ce boum qui redit boum à l'oreille. Tout a changé depuis hier et la rue a des yeux qui regardent aux fenêtres. Il y a du lilas et il y a des mains tendues sur la...
So, when we look at high angle rope rescue, one of the most common fails, if you will, is the edge transition when we navigate a rescue basket or rescue ladder over the edge of a building or a structure, but specifically a building where there's no parapet wall that would generally be considered a walk-off. It's not uncommon that in the absence of an AHD or artificial high direct or some kind of A-frame gantry, it's not uncommon for these evolutions to fail, and primarily, when I say fail, let's just say not go as well as they should. The primary reason, the most common reason, is that they fail to use adequate manpower in the correct location on the edge of the roof to properly manage the patient and the rescue litter, maintaining a horizontal orientation. To do this properly in the absence of a parapet wall or in the absence of a high anchor point or an AHD generally requires four edge persons. It requires two inside edge persons and it requires two outside edge persons. So that each corner of the rescue ladder is managed appropriately. Another method that is sometimes used is what is referred to as the V-strap method. The V-strap method, for various obvious reasons, and if you think about it, is actually a fallacy. Because it puts the patient into a vertical position and then you transition into a horizontal. I mean, if we're managing a patient's spinal condition, then you don't want to be in the vertical in the first place. If you're already in the vertical, then why take the time to transition to a horizontal? Another reason or a reason why sometimes there's not enough manpower or there's a reluctance to utilize outside edge persons is because some rescue sector officers or incident commanders feel that the outside edge is a hot zone, which it is, and therefore they're reluctant to place extra personnel in the hot zone, feeling that it's unsafe to do so. Put sufficient personnel into the structure fire to do the job, and you create a safer environment for everybody. Put sufficient personnel into the hot zone in a high angle rescue and you create a safer environment for everybody. Taking into account, obviously, not overloading your systems, not overloading your anchor points, and that your primary concern is to take care of your patient.
This video segment isn't intended to be training in itself. It's simply a demonstration of the process of an edge transition with a rescue basket. With all four edge persons in place, including obviously appropriate edge protection, we can now proceed with a very simple edge transition that maximizes patient care and safety for all persons involved.